If I die young, bury me in satin, lay me down.
Dear husband, I have had the most horrible of dreams last night. This was one where your noblemen were washing their filthy hands in your blood. The blood fell from your high and mighty statue.
Don't be foolish, Calpurnia. Thou art beginning to sound mad. Why must thee frighten your husband? I must go to work.
Alright team, welcome. We have been asked to do a strange case today. We're going to be investigating the murder of Julius Caesar that happened in BC.
Julius Caesar is in the Shakespeare play? You've got to be joking.
Look, I know this is a strange case, but we need to come up with the motive for this murder.
Okay, what do we have on the case?
Unfortunately, not much. Is everyone familiar with the case?
I'm not too sure I remember the story.
All I know is someone got stabbed a bunch of times.
Okay, so basically, Julius Caesar was an arrogant leader, and someone was fed up with it. That's what we have to find out. Who organized this murder? Rumor has it was all Caesar's followers that took turns stabbing him until he finally bled out.
So where do we begin? I mean, we can't have much evidence for a case that occurred centuries ago.
Well, we don't have much, but we do have a possible murder weapon. At a recent dig in ancient Rome, this weapon was found and believed to belong to one of the murderers who buried an attempt to cut at any threads linking him to the crime. It has blood traces remaining on it, so we need to take some tests done to it, Sam.
I'll take it to the lab. Allison, you should examine it and see if it's possible this weapon could even be used.
Alright, after you test it, just bring it to my office. I'll take a look at it. Send it to me first. I'll check for any fingerprints to find who this dagger actually was used by. Since there was multiple killers, though, we might not identify them all.
That still doesn't answer the question of who organized the crime. Killing a world leader back then was a very risky business. 1 ounce of evidence that you're linked to the crime when you're as good as dead. It must have been someone bold, someone they could never expect.
Like a poor family?
I bet it was a tough idea. His innocent wife? No one would expect a thing. It's a perfect time.
True. I bet it was Brutus. Caesar might... His right-hand man is probably the most unexpected person in this entire investigation. That would make him his perfect criminal, and it would truly be the perfect crime.
That still doesn't answer the question of who organized this crime. Killing a world leader back then was a very risky business. 1 ounce of evidence that you were linked to the crime, and you were as good as dead. It must have been someone bold, or someone they would never expect.
I bet it was Calpurnia. No one would expect his innocent wife to do such a thing. It's the perfect crime.
True.
I bet it was Brutus, Caesar's right-hand man. The most unexpected person in this entire investigation. That would make him the perfect criminal, and it truly would be the perfect crime.
Ladies, let's not argue about this right now. Let's get back to work and we'll see who guessed correctly. Report to me immediately if you find anything.
Based on how jagged the edges are on the blade, it suggests that it could cut through human flesh.
You have a dog like this, you know they poop a lot.
Did you just say your dog poops?
A lot. Well, then you need to buy the pooper scooper. Scoops up the poop, just like that.
Pooper scooper, buy one today.
Okay, ladies, have we cracked the case?
Well, the dagger is certainly sharp enough to cut through human flesh. The edges were so jagged that it would be like a hot knife cutting through butter.
The blood was a match to the famous Julius Caesar.
Any word on the fingerprints? They could be the key to cracking this case. If the knife belonged to one of our initial suspects, it's safe to say they were the ringleader in the whole murder plan.
Well, it was difficult to figure out who they belonged to because of how old the dagger was. But after a few days of searching, I found a match. The prints belonged to the one and only Brutus.
So he was the murderer? Just by himself? He was stabbed 33 times. I feel like there's more to the story than that.
It wasn't him by himself, but because we only have the one weapon, and that weapon definitely belonged to Brutus, he is our lead suspect.
So your final report is Brutus is behind the murder of Julius Caesar?
Absolutely, and now there's evidence that proves that.
And he had motive. Brutus was fed up with how Julius Caesar would walk around all full of himself. He just had enough.
Great job, ladies. You solved the case.
Wait, we have to talk.
No, hold on.
Okay. So basically,
Brutus get my mind.
Let out.
The one evidence and that one weapon definitely belonged to Brutus, he is our lead suspect.